I'm here at an evening of the university, the Hogeschool from Utrecht, looking at innovations which students came up with. Now, one of the pitches which was not here was Robert Balak, but he made a beautiful product and he did crowdsourcing, and I'm going to present it now. Robert, what is your product?
So my product's basically like a wallet for keys. It's like, I call it the Rhino Key. So yeah, it's like a product you can store your keys inside. It's a wide range of different keys. So you have both sides. It's very compact and it's made of titanium. And as well as organizing your keys, you can as well do some function with it, like opening a beer. You have a flathead screwdriver. You have even at night, you can see the keyhole with a light. So it's perfectly integrated in the design.
And I can say, hey, I mean, he didn't say anything. He just showed me, and it feels wonderful. Titanium. You can basically just push it with your finger, push the keys out, put it in. It's beautiful. It's really fantastic. What do you do at school?
So I'm studying mechanical engineering. So at school, yeah, we learn how to go from idea to product and how to design.
You learned that last year.
Yeah. So I'm now at fourth year of my study. So I'm now I'm finished. Like in 2 months, almost finished.
Okay. But I mean, and when did you made this during your study? So
yeah. No, well, it's not a study assignment, but
you made it for yourself, and you basically learned all the lessons. Yeah. Now, how did you find the market for this product? Is there a market for this product?
Yeah, so actually that's very simple. There are some ideas about storing keys in different kind of designs. So I've integrated three kind of products. Firstly, a key organizer itself. And second, like a multi-tool. And third is a flashlight. And I integrated these three products into one.
Yeah, but I mean, I am asking now, this is about a product, it's beautiful, it's fantastic, feels great. How did you find the market for it?
Yeah, so I basically began by searching down a niche with where I'm passionate about. Yeah. So I started with finding a coach, actually. Starting to find a coach in crowdfunding, because there was something I thought, yeah, it's really interesting. Yeah. So I got a coach, and that coach made a product inside a niche, which is EDC, Everyday Carry Niche. It's a very passionate niche. So I designed something in the EDC niche, and to see if there's a market for this, I searched.
Don't keep us into suspense. I mean, so you put the crowdsourcing, and I think you wanted to have 4,000 euro, right? I mean, how much is this product?
50.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's 49 euros.
49 euros, so it's $50, and I mean, and you wanted 4,000 euro in sale. That was your minimum goal, right?
Yeah.
And how much did you make?
Like over $100,000.
Over $100,000. So this guy made during his study a really, I mean, you cannot see it on the camera, but it's he has made a nice video, which I will link to. But it feels great. And you push the keys out with your thumb. You can do it blindly. So it's really, it's a beautiful, and it's also very well designed. And then you got 95,000. How amazed were you when you saw the sales taking off?
Yeah, so I was shocked, because on the first day it went really well, and I used social media to leverage the power of making any sales to get some traffic to the Kickstarter campaign, and afterwards it kept rolling and going. And you know, I did spend some on marketing, but that's basically you need to market a product online. And
yeah, but I mean, the enthusiasm of people, and then basically this is something you're passionate about. I am passionate about it. I immediately wanted to make a movie out of it. And now you want to go to China and basically visit all kinds of potential producers, right? I mean, do you already made the first batch, or are you going to China basically figuring out what to do?
So everything is planned from A to Z, and for now, for the Kickstarter campaign. Yeah. And to make things easier, and to maybe there's a version 2 in a few months. Yeah. So I basically want to go to China to see if I can build a relationship with manufacturers as well as making some improvements on the product.
Okay. So you're going to China, and he wants to basically figure out who can make this titanium stuff. I mean, in Shenzhen, you basically source the light, the flashing light, right? I mean, that is... That's the product from Shenzhen. Yeah. Where does the rest come from?
So actually, the PCB inside is manufactured in Shenzhen. Yeah. And the titanium Rhino Key itself is CNC machining in Guangzhou.
Yeah. And it's, I mean, how happy are you about the quality and about the contact with the manufacturer and what they wanted to do?
So. I tried different suppliers at first, and I tried different samples, like three suppliers. I contacted 20. I nailed it down on language, I nailed it down on communication, and afterwards on quality. So I got three samples, and then look at the three samples, and afterwards this was the best quality I can get.
What did you think of the process? You basically come up with a product, you make one sample yourself, and then you go to China, you use WhatsApp, you didn't go there, right? I mean, you just did everything online. How well were you treated? How well was it? How easy was it to communicate with them? And how happy are you with the result?
Well, the initial contact with suppliers was harder, like 20 suppliers contacting. And afterwards, there were like 10 Chinese suppliers that could really talk good English. But then they lacked communication, so I nailed it down to even further.
But now you have three, and now you have sample. How happy are you?
Very happy. Yeah.
How easy is it to work with China?
Very well. Easy, really easy. So, like, they stand, like, in the evening at our time, it's night there, and they're still responding.
They work hard.
They work really.
And the quality is the quality of the product.
Amazing. Yeah. Amazing. Yeah.
And compared to the price they charge for it,
it's nuts. Yeah.
Did you try how much it would be in Holland?
Yeah, and that's a 10x.
10x. Okay. So if a student can basically come up with a product, get 100,000 on sales in crowdsourcing, and then go to China and basically source it, make it happen, so can you. Get off your butt and basically get it going. Okay. And good luck with your trip to China.
Thank you very much.